السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا
إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت، وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحابه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا وحبيبنا وقائدنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، يقول الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله، اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أوصوا الله سبحانه وتعالى تلقى في سورة البقرة بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. My dear brother and sister of Islam, I began today by saying all praise, all gratitude, and all thanks belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we seek refuge in Allah from the sin that we commit and the faults within ourselves. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide, no one could misguide. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leads astray, no one could guide. We bear witness there is no deity worthy to worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we bear witness indeed Prophet Muhammad alayhi afdal wa askar salam, his final and his last messenger. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless Prophet Muhammad and his family and his companion, and whoever follow him until the judgment day, Allahumma ameen. I shared with you a couple of verses from the Holy Quran, the first verse from Surah Ali Imran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he addressed us by saying, O you believe, fear Allah as we should be feared, and die not unless you are in the state of Islam. The second verse from Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O mankind, worship your Lord, who created you, and those who were before you, so that you may become pious. My dear brother and sister Islam, today's khutbah, inshallah, it will be about verse from Surah Al-Dariyat. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. We're going to be talking about مَا هِيَ الْعِبَادَةِ. What is the ibadah is all about, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expecting and demanding from us here while we're living on earth. Most of us sometimes we think an ibadah, brother and sister, is praying, paying zakah, fasting, and hajj, and that's it. But really, wallahi, wallahi, if you think about it and read the Holy Quran, understand what the Holy Quran, it's way more than that. It's huge, it's big. And a lot of stuff is that we go over our head and we do not pay attention. So today I'm going to try to open our eyes and heart to understand what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really expected from us when He said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْثَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا هِيَ الْعِبَادَةِ. This is what we're going to be talking about, brother and sister. So now, here you notice Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said al-jinn before al-ins. What does that mean? We understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created jinn before us on human being. And then after that, He created us as a human being. So what is the jinn is made out of? Who is the jinn? Brother and sister, the jinn is being, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him from fire, flame. And the jinn, there is good and there is bad. And there is Muslim and there is kafir. And they live with us on earth. They can see us, but we cannot see them. And I'm going to share that with you from Surah Ar-Rahman. And then also we, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you know, He created us from salsali, from clay. And let me share with you from Surah Ar-Rahman, بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. خلق الإنسان من صلصال كالفخار. And that's us. وخلق الجان من مارج من نار فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. See, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created us from salsal, and He created الجان الجن from نار. Brother and sister, now sometimes, and also I'd like to remind you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a choice to worship and to pray, and He gives us a choice not to do that too. Because among us as a human being, there is kafir. There's people who do not pray, do not believe there's Allah. In the jinn, the same thing, the same way. But the angels are different from the jinn and the human being and the ants, which is us. And brother and sister, angel, they have no choice but to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 7 days, 24 hours a day. They have no other choice. And then also I'd like to bring your attention, we are not the only, we're not only the human being or the things that we are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us to worship Allah. The human being is not the only creation that Allah put us here on earth to worship. Everything between the heaven and the earth worship Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Al-Wahid Al-Ahad Allah. And I would like to share with that with you from Surah An-Nur, بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألم تر أن الله يسبح له من في السماوات والأرض والطير صافات كل قد علم صلاته وتسبيحه والله عليم بما يفعلون. Don't you see that everything between the heavens and the earth praises Allah, as you do as the birds with their wings spread wide open, and everyone knows their way how to pray and to praise Allah, and Allah knows well what we do. So brother and sister, so the birds, animals, the mountains, everything between the heaven and earth is worship Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim in its own way. We do not know how, but God knows. But God knows. So brother and sister, what else about the ibadah, about prostrating? We're coming here to do ibadah. We came here to worship Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim and prostrate. But again, it's beyond that. I'm going to go a little bit further. So for example, we come here for the salah. صلاة برادر اند سيستر يس ات از عبادة بس وي نيد تو فوكس اون اور صلاة. وي نيد تو ليف ذا اوت سايد وورلد not to be here as a body and also standing up and prostrating, but you're really doing business with someone in your own mind and you're not really focusing on your salah. And we're supposed to, of course, to pray at least 5 times a day beside the sunnah. So this is the salah. About also ibadah is the zakah. We're supposed to pay zakah, to pay it on a timely manner and to pay it correctly and to give it to the poor and the needy. This is also ibadah. Also the siyam, siyam shahr Ramadan. So siyam shahr Ramadan, very, very important to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we need to fast on the month of Ramadan. Also Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to fast Thursday and Monday outside of the month of Ramadan. And also Hajj, فَمَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. So whoever can, physically and financially, go and perform Hajj, it's an obligation, it's also ibadah. So brother and sister, so also as-sabr, being patient, is ibadah. If you face major difficulties, major disaster, accident, anything happening to you or to your family, and you exercise patience, this is ibadah. This is your art because you are accepting Allah's will. You are accepting what qada'ullahi wa qadar. So this is considered ya'adna ta'bud Allah because you are accepting what has taken place. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us in Surah Al-Baqarah ba'd bismillahir rahmanir rahim ya ayyuhalladhina amanu ista'inu bis-sabri was-salah. If you notice here, as-sabr came before salah. That means it's important to Allah. When anything, any calamity you face, could exercise sabr. The sabr was salah. Inna Allah ma'a as-sabrin. Allah will be with the one they are exercising patience. Also, beside that ibadah, to be truthful with others, the way you conduct business, that's ibadah. When you are giving the employee their money, you're not cheating anyone. You're saying the truth. This is ibadah. Why? Because you have fear of Allah. You know you're going to be judged. You're going to be judged. Why did you lie? Why did you cheat? Why did you do this? So or misleading someone. When you refrain from misleading someone, or cheating, or lying, and you say, no, I'm not going to do that. And that now you are worshiping Allah. Now you know Allah is here, brother and sister. And also to witness and to say, yes, I saw him doing that, and you are lying. That's not ibadah. But you say, no, I did not see anything. That's ibadah. Let me share that with you from Surah Al-Furqan. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَشْهَدُونَ الزُّورِ وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِاللَّغْوِ مَرُّوا كِرَامًا. Well, those who do not witness a falsehood, and if they pass by people backbiting, they stay away from it and with dignity. Another word, you're not listening to gossip. Okay, beside shahd zur or the false witnesses, but lahwi means that you are not doing gossiping or backbiting or in vain conversation against someone or listening. So stay away from that. That's also ibadah. What else is ibadah? Also to protect yourself from having any sexual contact with anyone except your wife. And you're fearing Allah, you say, no, I'm not going to look at haram. I'm not going to exercise haram. I'm not going to do this with anyone except my spouse. And this is also ibadah. Let me share with you, I remind you about Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam. When he had an opportunity with the wife of the minister of Egypt, and she was trying to seduce him, she tried doing advances to have sexual relationship with him. What it came to his mind? Immediately, Allah. And he said, no, I'm not going to be involved with this lady. And it was an opportunity for him. She had the money, she had the looks, she had the prestige, but what he stopped him? Ibadat Allah. And he said, no, I'm not going to do that. And he backed off. Also, what else besides ibadah, besides salah and siyam, whatever I said? Also, to be kind to another. First of all, you need to be kind to who first? Your parent, to your spouse, to your family, to your neighbor, and also silat al-rahim, your uncle, your grandparent, all those, the closest one to you, you have to be kind, and also to say something nice to the people that you know or you do not know. And let me share that with you from Surah Al-Baqarah, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا تعبدون إلا الله وبالوالدين إحسانا وذو القربى واليتامى والمساكين وقولوا للناس حسنا. And tell the people here to be, do not worship anyone except Allah, and then to be kind to who? To your parent immediately. والوالدين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he put إلا تعبدون إلا الله. And then right next to it, to be kind to your parent. And then go to the qurba, wal yatama, the poor and the needy, and to be kind to them, and also to be nice to everyone around you and say something nice or kind. If you're not going to say something nice or kind, don't say nothing. Be quiet. And let me share with you a story that it happened to me just a couple months ago. I've been in a gasoline business for about 45 or 48 years. And also around the gas station constantly we see people coming in to with a gas can and say, I ran out of gas and can you please give us, and they chase the customer around. I'm sure both of all of you have seen them. And then they chase the people, say, give me some money to put some gas, and probably he's not out of gas. But it's a way to get money for all the people to feed his family or to his needs. I ran into one of those guys, we're in Costco parking lot. And then, we've been facing difficulty finding employees. And then this guy approached me with a gas can, and he said, well, can you give me some money to put gas in the car? Because I'm running out of gas. So I've been hearing these tricks. Some of them are real, but most of them are tricks. And then this person, he came in to me, and then I said, why don't you go find a job? And because I cannot even find cashiers in my gas station. I said, go find a job. There's jobs everywhere in the city of New Bagan. And I said that, and after I said that, I said, I shouldn't have said that. I should have been calm and be quiet. And then I go to my car to write to start my car. My car doesn't want to start. I said, oops. And this man, he comes into me, the same guy. And he said, you cannot start your car. I said, no. He said, you want me to help you? You want me to bring my car to give you a job? I said, oh my gosh. I should not say that. I should say something kind or be quiet. Because it will catch up with you. From that day, I learned, if I'm not going to say something nice, I'll be quiet. So take it from me as advice. Always say something للناس حسنا. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tell us in the Holy Quran. So we need to apply what we heard and take it as advice. So brother and sister, now, also a shukr. Thanking Allah is ibadah. And it's big chapter about that. So since we have the next Thursday, I believe it's going to be Thanksgiving holiday, which is, I believe, November 24th. And here, which is a very good holiday, I really admire and I have respect for the American people that they taking that day off and closing their business to do what? To thank Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Al-Wahid Al-Ahad Allah about his bounty. But as Muslim brother and sister, we continue to not to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or to thank Allah once a year and to recognize no, or once a year or once a week. For every breath you are taking, every morning that you wake up, and you must say Alhamdulillah and to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for every breath that you are taking. Because we do not know when we were leaving or so on. Let me remind you, there is one of our community, our marhum Sayyid Ali Ibrahim Al-Awni, which is Adil Abu Khalid, which is Nasir Abdullah. He was doing fine. I was with him about 3 weeks ago. Yesterday, He did not wake up from his bed. He did not wake up from his bed. And now this is why Brother Bilal and Brother Rami, they're not here today. They went to help to bury him. So brother and sister, for every morning, say Alhamdulillah, and he was healthy. He walks and he's not overweight or anything, but he had some difficulties in his heart and he passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yataqabbalahu wa bless rahmatu ya rahmat rahim ya Allah. So brother and sister, so we need to be thankful also about everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us. Look at how many kinds of food that we have on our plate. Or we're gonna have next Thursday, turkey, rice, salad, meat, all kind of meat, and all that stuff. A lot of us, we do exercise that day, and because it's a neutral day, we are thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I don't have a problem with thanking Allah, not only once a year, all the time. And every time you sit down and eat, you should also thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us in Surah Al-Nahl, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. If you try to count the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will not be able to count one item. Nothing. Because it's way beyond what you have seen already, brother and sister. And also, I want to bring your attention every day when we are praying. We pray at least 17 times a day. I mean, we are reciting Al-Fatiha at least 17 times a day if we are praying 5 times. And what do we say in the beginning, which is what is the first surah in the Holy Quran? We say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Malik Yawm Al-Din. Do you, when you say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, do you say it with really the meaning? Or you say it mechanically, but you really don't comprehend the weight of the word when you are saying Alhamdulillah? So you must say, brother, sister, understand the weight of the word, and you mean it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you really thank Allah. Do not say it mechanically, and you really thinking of business and you're doing something else in your own mind. No, because sometimes we do that. So I would like to remind you, when you say it with passion, and you really mean addressing it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, I wanted to remind you, when the khatib is taught, this way you understand, alhamdulillah, or shukrullah, very, 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 very big. A khatib, when every khatib, you start to hear on every masjid. What do you understand, and you hear the first thing he say? Inna alhamdulillah, nahmadahu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'firuh. Immediately before he started, he thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what does he say when he toward the end of his khutbah? اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزيدكم. This is how important it is. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he put it as a demand before the khatib start to thank Allah. And when before he ends, to thank Allah. That's meaning thanking Allah is very, very important. Well, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also في سورة النحل, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us about his bounty that he gives us. بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والله أخرجكم من بطون أمهاتكم لا تعلمون شيئا وجعل لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة لعلكم تشكرون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, he got you out of your mother's womb. Do not understand anything, do not know anything, and he give you eyes, ear, tongue, and heart. You're gonna say, but brother, there's some people are born blind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or deaf. So what happened to those? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he did not give him that too? I'm gonna answer you. Allah, this way you appreciate what you have. He's showing you, you could be like that. You could be blind. And then I wanted to test one time, do not use your eyesight for 3 days. Cover your eyes for 3 days. And then you remove the cover. You're gonna say, whoa, I understand how valuable it is. So I don't have to be there. Now here's a tester of their brother and sister. So always think thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's a huge difference between الشاكر والشكور. ما هو الفرق؟ الله سبحانه وتعالى تقول في سورة سبع: وأعملوا آل داود شكرا وقليل من عبادي الشكور. أجل؟ اعملوا آل داود شكرا وقليل من عبادي الشكور. Here Allah سبحانه وتعالى he said in this verse there is a big difference between شاكر and شكور. شاكر brother and sister when a person he faces positive things, goodness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he said, Ashkurak ya Rab for a brand new car, Ashkurak ya Rab for a new arrival baby, or a raise came from his boss. Thank you, Lord. And this is the positive. Ashkur? No. Ashkur, if anything could happen to him, positive or negative, he continued Shakur. He always say, Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, never, whatever it happened, he always thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إن الله هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وخاتم الأنبياء سيدنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله. My dear brother and sister, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He lifted us to a high level on earth. We are His favorite creation on earth. We are His favorite among the animals, the mountains, anything on earth, we can put us in His that his favor. And بقوله تعالى في سورة الإسراء بعد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ وَحَمَلْنَاهُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ وَرَزَقْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى كَثِيرٍ مِمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically still us here. We carried them on earth with the animals. And also on boats in the sea, and we give them طيبات, goodness, and then we put them on a rank higher than anything that we have created on earth. We are the highest rank on earth according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should be really thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are the leaders on earth. Not the animal is leading us, or the bird is leading us. No, we are in charge of earth, and we should take care of the earth, because this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us as a gift. Also, I would like to share with you before we close from Surah Al-Baqarah, by Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. الله سبحانه وتعالى يشتري رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: If my servant asks you about me, tell them I will respond to their call or to their dua. And also another verse, Allah سبحانه وتعالى tells us: وقال ربكم ادعوني استجب لكم. ادعوني استجب لكم. إن الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي سيدخلون جهنم داخلين. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put الدُّعاء العبادة in one verse. Another word, when you raise your hand and you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for things, you are exercising عبادة. Because you are acknowledging that He is a sustainer. You acknowledge He is the Ghani. You acknowledge He is the giver. You're acknowledging He's the owner when you do it, calling your God and say, God, help me. God, give this person. God, this is also ibadah. This is ibadah, brother and sister. إِنَّ اللَّهُ مَلَائِكَتُهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وقال ربكم ادعوني استجب لكم اللهم احفظ المسلمين والمسلمات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، اللهم اعف عنا وعن أبائنا وأمهاتنا من عذاب النار، وتوفنا مع الأبرار. يا منزل الماء من السماء، يا مخرج النبات من الأرض، يا من قلت للنار كوني بردا وسلاما على إبراهيم، اعف عنا وارحمنا وتقبلنا بواسع رحمتك يا رحمن يا رحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. يا مالك يوم الدين، يا قوي يا عزيز يا رحمن يا رحيم، أدخلنا الفردوس الأعلى. اللهم أمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم واقم الصلاه ان الصلاه كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا. الشيخ علي شمس الدين اخر صلاه كان يسال دعاء للمرحوم علي ابراهيم سوبريز المحسن الشيستي. امين.
الله اكبر الله اكبر، اشهد ان لا اله الا الله، اشهد ان محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاه، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
جزاكم الله استغفر الله رحمه الله ثوبه فإن تسوها تصبره من تمام الصلاة. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ألم تر أن الله يسبح له من في السماوات والأرض والطير صافات كل قد علم صلاته وتسبيحه والله عليم بما يفعلون. ولله ملك السماوات والأرض وإلى الله المصير. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله إن
شاء الله نعمل دعاء لأخونا المحفوظ الحاج علي إبراهيم لأولي علي أبو خالد الحاج ناصر إن شاء الله اللهم تغمده برحمتك يا رب العالمين اللهم أسكنه فسيح جناتك اللهم نقيه من خطاياه كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس اللهم أدخله وأدخلنا الجنة دون سابقة عذاب يا رب العالمين اللهم وسع له في قبره واجعل قبره روضة من رياض الجنة وحاسبه حسابا يسيرا اللهم حاسبه حسابا يسيرا اللهم احشره واحشرنا في زمرة نبينا وتحت لواء حبيبنا واسقنا واسقه بيد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم شرفة هنيئة مليئة لا يظمأ بعدها أبدا ولا نظمأ بعدها أبدا اللهم لا تحرمنا أجره ولا تفتنا بعده واغفر لنا وله يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعل له نورا على الصراط اللهم اجعل له نورا يوم القيامة في حشره وفي ميزانه يا رب العالمين اللهم ارحمه وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اللهم ارحمه وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين ببركة القرآن العظيم وبحرمة من أرسلته رحمة للعالمين واعف عنه واعف عنا يا كريم واعف عنه واعف عنا يا رحيم اللهم إنه الآن أصبح في ضيافتك وأنت كريم وضيف الكريم لا يضاف فلا تضفه يا رب العالمين ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.